Borra means hole in Odia language, and Guhalu means caves in Telugu language. Sounds interesting, right? How about we call them as hole caves? Anyway, let's start our tour of Borra Guhalu now. Read the board on the right side for information about the caves. This is the entrance to the caves. The entrance measures 100 meters horizontally and 75 meters vertically. These caves are one of the largest and deepest caves in India. Necessary infrastructure is in place for the visitor to access all parts of the caves easily. There are many levels in the caves, the deepest being 80 meters. The changing color of the light makes the rock surface beautiful. Have you noticed it? If not, please watch carefully. The atmosphere in the caves is even made livelier by the voices and shouting of the visitors. You will be scared if you are alone in the caves with the surrounding silence. As you walk in the caves, notice the interesting forms and shapes that are formed. Be careful as you walk, since some of the pathways are too narrow. Enjoy your rest of the tour. I'll be back soon.
Thank you. often?
ఇంకా బైక్ వెళ్తున్నాము.
I am back again. I am glad that you have covered all parts of the cave. Take care while you walk back to the entrance of the caves. Before we sign off, I am providing you some more information about the caves. These caves are discovered in 1807 by William King George of Geological Survey of India. Gostani River originates from these caves. Water percolating from the roof of the caves dissolved limestone and trickled drop by drop to form stalactites at the roof of the cave, and then dripping down to the ground forms stalagmites. Don't worry if you don't understand this. These deposits have developed into interesting forms and structures inside the caves, such as Shiva Parvati, Mother Child, Rishi's bird, human brain, etc. The tribals who live in the villages around the caves narrate different legends about the caves. The popular legend is that a cow grazing on the top of the caves dropped 60 meters through a hole in the roof. The cow herd, while searching for the cow, came across the caves. He found a stone inside the cave that resembled a lingam, which he interpreted as the Lord Shiva who protected the cow. The village folk who heard the story believed it, and since then they have built a small temple for Lord Shiva outside the cave. People flock to the temple for worship and the cave to get a glimpse of the lingam. The fauna observed in the caves are predominantly bats as well as the golden gecko. That's all for now. I hope you enjoyed your tour of Borra Caves. I wish you good luck and have a safe ride back to home.